So that was really quick. So I'm going to try to remove this capacitor here. And that just works absolutely phenomenal. Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to be taking a look at these tweezers. These are soldering iron tweezers. They're called the Yihua 938D hot tweezers. So it's basically a soldering iron in tweezer form, and both sides do heat up. It's pretty insane. It's a kind of a station also. You can choose the exact temperature that you want to work on, which I found pretty awesome. So we're going to see how well and how useful this thing actually works, and if you might need one or not. Well, obviously, first of all, if you do a lot of SMD work, this will be very useful, and it cuts down time quite significantly. And we'll take a look at that in a little bit. So obviously you get the soldering iron itself, you do get the carrying thing, and as well as the sponge here. Now this wire connects to the station, which is just this little portable thingy. Now I really wish this had some weight or something, because it's really annoying to place this somewhere. But the wires are very good, they're silicone, they don't get in the way, they're very flexible, which is really good to see here. And you don't risk the chance of actually burning through these wires, which is also very good. Now let's take a look at the control board here. So as you can tell, we could choose between Celsius and Fahrenheit. And here is where we go ahead and choose the temperature. So let's boot this guy up on Celsius and let's set it up to the minimum. So Celsius, it runs at 200 degrees Celsius minimum, and the maximum is 480 degrees Celsius. Now, if you wanted to see Fahrenheit, we can just flip that over. So the minimum is 392 degrees Fahrenheit, and the maximum it runs on is 896 degrees Fahrenheit. So let's go ahead and set this up to around 370, 380. Now the thing is with this, when I place it somewhere, right now if I go ahead and move it and try to set it down somewhere, usually I tend to hit this dial here and it'll change the temperature slightly. So yeah, take that into consideration. That's one thing that I currently don't like, but it's not really a deal breaker for me because this thing is very useful. So let me set that down real quick. And let's get started on something. So while this heats up, I'm just gonna make sure the tip is clean. And yep, it reached temperature here, so that's perfect. So let's put this guy to the side and let's grab ourselves a little board here. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and test this out. We're gonna go ahead and test out trying to installing a capacitor first. And let's see how we would go about doing this. Now, I don't think this is the correct method here, which is using it to add solder, but this sounds very logical to me. I've never used the hot tweezer before, so we're gonna see how well that does. All right, so I probably added a bit too much here, but that's totally fine because I'm not using any flux because I ran out of flux right now. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna try to install one of these capacitors and see how easy it is to actually install. So I'm gonna grab this one right there, all right? And I'm gonna go ahead and just drop it in. So that was really quick. So I'm gonna try to remove this capacitor here. And that just works absolutely phenomenal. Now, as you can tell, I'm using a silicone pad. I got this from Banggood. It is absolutely phenomenal. You just, no matter how long you keep it there, it just won't burn anything. As you can tell, I could just keep it there all day and nothing, which is just beautiful. That's why I'm able to just pick stuff up and then just go ahead and move them. All right, so let's go ahead and just reinstall this one. I'm going to try to reinstall it, see how easy it'll make it. So I didn't have a good grab on it. Now, if you added some flux here, or if I still had some flux inside the solder, it would just fall right in beautifully, but it's still working absolutely nice. I mean, this will cut down time like crazy. So if you want to remove three capacitors, let's just see how quick we could remove three caps here, three SMD caps. All right. Okay, so I'm just using these little tweezers here. Probably clean this up a little. Did we remove that one? Remove that one. We removed all of them. One, two, three, and one is still stuck on this guy. All right, so that was really quick and really easy. So let's just say we wanted to go ahead and replace it with a brand new cap. Just gonna set this up. This is very good for repairing flight controllers and all kinds of other SMD components here that you really wanted to kind of start learning how to repair. So it's just absolutely phenomenal. Now I'm not getting a perfect job done here because the board is very far away from me, and it's still pretty amazing that I'm able to get these kind of results even though I'm hella far away from this, which I find pretty impressive, to be honest. I didn't expect a $50 tweezer soldering iron would be this useful. I thought it was just, you know, just something just to catch your eye, you get it, and you probably never use it. But I have this set up right next to me now. I'll be using this a lot more often, especially with the repair and debugging videos. It's just going to make everything super easy. All right, so let's just try to do a little bit more. So I don't think you should add the solder with the current soldering iron, this one here. And it's still new, so I still need to feed it a lot of solder. So I should definitely add some flux here. But it's okay, I just don't have any right now. There we go. So I'm adding a lot of solder here. I'm not supposed to add that much, but that's totally fine. So let's go ahead and install a new one here. There we go. It's very simple, very easy, and to be honest, very, very addictive. I'm really enjoying this. I mean, I could sit here and do so many little DIY projects just to enjoy this little soldering machine or this little soldering tweezers. I don't even know what they're called. I think they're calling them hot tweezers. It's the first time ever I've ever used something like this, which is, but it's just so easy to use. It's really insane. I mean, to try to do this with just a normal soldering iron, it's kind of difficult, but I mean, with patience, you can get it just right. Look at that, it just goes right in. And obviously with this, I need a little bit more practice, but it's still getting the job perfect. So I'm gonna try to remove every single one on here as quick as possible. Thing is, it just sticks, there we go. We need a way to clean them faster. Do you see the speed? This is really crazy. And especially with hot air. Now, you don't have to risk burning the whole board. You can just, you know, grab the exact component that you need. Obviously, this won't work for ICs, but it's very useful for diodes, capacitors, resistors, and just a lot of other things that tend to usually just blow out first. So we didn't have anything there. You see how quick? It's gorgeous. It's absolutely beautiful. I mean, that is just insane. So I'm going to go ahead and try to actually put these up in a row. And if you're curious where I got these tweezers, I'll leave a link to them down below. These are ceramic tweezers, really nice. And SMD components tend to not like to stick to this, which I really like compared to the metal ones. That's just a huge advantage for me. Obviously, if it has some solder on it, it'll stick. But like, I mean, the solder paste, it'll stick and stuff like that. But overall, it's just it's really nice. I really like it. So let's just try to put a couple more back. So here's one. See how quick we can do this. All right, here's another one. And here's another one. I'm looking through the camera screen to do this, and it's a very small screen. So if I'm making mistakes, it's actually so much easier. I mean, it's so easy to set this up, especially obviously, if you don't have a camera and a microphone in your face, or you're not looking through a small screen, it's just phenomenal here. There we go. It's just, it's very satisfying. Very, very satisfying here. And what's so cool about the silicone pad, I don't have to worry about contaminating the solder iron, the tips here. So it's really good that I could just come in, grab them, and not have to worry about burning anything below the pad here or the pad itself, which I really like about these silicone pads, especially this new one. Try not to get white, because white will become very, very filthy. And I had a white one previously, but this one is just gorgeous. It's really nice. After I'm done, I just clean this up, and then it's just brand new. There we go. It's very easy to see the SMD components also on this little mat here. It's just like, it's like a magnet in there. It's just crazy the way it works. Obviously, some of these will need a little bit of fixing, but overall, this thing is just functioning absolutely gorgeous. So let's go ahead and try to remove a component from this flight controller. And I'm going to try to go for something a little bit big, because it's very difficult to see from this far away. And I totally see this one right here. So this is, I think it's a little diode or something. So let's go ahead and take this out. See how easy it is. Oh, wow. That was super simple. So let's go ahead and see if we can put this back in. And that should be in. Yep, that is in. As you can tell. So let's remove it again. It's really addictive. Wow, that was quick. So just make sure you have something on the side just to remove it so it doesn't burn the component, especially if it's not broken. So like this one, still good. So let's try to put that back in here. Here we go. I'm just going to add a little push here. There we go. Just to straighten it out. So that's in perfect. So it's really nice. It's a really nice board. I'm going to remove these dirty tantalum capacitors here. There we go. And there we go. It is gorgeous. So it's going to be really useful and it'll really save a lot of time and cut down time, a lot of time, especially if you're working with these and you're just, you're not really experienced or really experienced. I think it's very useful. Some people might prefer still to do hot air. I do too, but actually if it's just a small component like this, I'm not going to go ahead and risk the hot air. I'm still not that experienced with hot air. And I think this does the job absolutely phenomenal. And I totally recommend it for SMD work. And especially on the channel, we're going to be doing a lot of new projects. So it might be very useful to some out there. And it's only $45. I mean, that's what's so crazy about this. It's a $45 soldering station, basically, which is absolutely phenomenal. And, well, that's it, guys. I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. And this was my review of the Yihua 938D Hot Tweezers. And they're just really addictive and really, really satisfying to work with. I've just been playing with it all day. And, well, that's it, guys. I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. The link to this will be down below if you could use those to greatly support the channel. And if you guys have any questions or any suggestions, feel free to let me know. And I will see you next time. Peace out, guys.